206. You know what I'm talking about? Prez Potter, Rain City Bullies, Prez Entertainment. The first big name dog on my yard was Iron Cass's white Rhino, produced by Mike Lynn's Kennels off of Mike Lynn Cracker and Mike Lynn's Ghost. White Rhino was a very, very extreme dog, about 17 inches tall, 85 to 88 pounds tops, 24 inch head, bone, chest that was unmatchable at the time. Just a very, very extreme dog. There wasn't too many dogs that was stacking with him. Those who caught him out, they stacked, and wasn't a good thing for them. He was my first major dog because he was pound for pound probably the most extreme dog of his time. White Rhino was a special dog to me because he was my ideal dog. I'm really into the extreme dogs, massive bone, girth, blocky head, short muzzle, and all in all, he was special because he wasn't just my dog, he was my son. The second of record straight on the purchase of White Rhino, it wasn't $260,000 cash. I also do real estate on top of some other stuff, and I have about three or four properties at that time, and I went ahead and gave one of my properties to the current owner of White Rhino for the purchase of White Rhino. He turned around, lived in the house for 6-7 months, sold it for about $260,000. So the value of the property was I absolutely believe White Rhino was worth every penny. Not only was he a very special dog to me and to my family, but he's loved all across this country. People still come up to me and tell me how much they love my dogs. I still do interviews about my dog. Very special dog, one of a kind. A lot of people didn't give his real props until after his passing, but he got his just dues. Very, very worth it. I'd do it all over again if I had the opportunity. Take a shot in remembrance of my boy White Rhino, rest in peace. Right here is where Rhino lays. Yep, rest in peace, Woo Woo. That's what we called him. Of course, I still got straws on White Rhino.